hallucinogenics on WROI. And I got a gentleman across the board from me here who says, you don't want to trip on hallucinogenics.
It's not a good thing.
Woodlawn CEO John Alley, how you doing today, sir?
Doing great. Getting a little bit cooler weather. You know, fall's coming in. I kind of like that time of the year. So looking forward to much better things as the future progresses.
Well, I'm all about better things.
Yes, we've kind of been through the ringer, so to speak, I think, the whole country. And, you know, there is this now tiny glimmer of light, I think, at the end of that tunnel. Just go take time. We're going to get there. And, you know, everybody just needs to be patient as we move toward that. Hopefully, we'll get back somewhat to normal. I'm not sure we'll ever see complete normal again. But if we can get 95% of it, I think it'd be a good thing.
I'm okay with 95%.
Yeah, me too. So I think everybody's just getting really tired of everything we're going through right now.
Yes.
And, you know, it will get better. Hang in there. It's up to us to make it better, and we'll get there. Board meeting yesterday, so it was quite a lot of we discussed yesterday. So, you know, some things that we're doing that I think is going to be a benefit to the community. You know, one of the things that we're doing that the hospital staff is going to be participating in a fundraiser. And it's called the Cribs for Kids Breath of Life Stroll. Every year, about 3,600 babies die of SIDS or accidental suffocation in the U.S. Woodlawn Hospital is a nationally certified safe sleep leader, and we're working to change that statistic in our community. We encourage the community to join us in our efforts to raise funds to provide cribs for families in need. 100% of the funds raised stay in our community. So for every $60 raised, that could save a baby's life. Because, you know, a lot of times folks don't have the money for a crib or a safe crib. So this program will put cribs in those people's hands. So let's help more babies in our community make it to their first birthday. Safe sleep saves lives. You can donate or register online to be part of the Woodlawn Hospital team. You can see our Facebook page for details. The stroll starts October 1st. So basically, we're wanting to raise money. You don't have to, you know, give birth in our facility. If you need a crib, you contact our OB department, and we'll make arrangements to get you that crib. And, you know, a lot of babies, people think, oh, I'll just put them in bed with me. Well, you roll, they roll, and all of a sudden we have an accident. So we're wanting to prevent that in our community. So the Cribs for Kids Breath of Life Stroll, please help us raise the funds so we can get cribs to those needed families. Then the other news that we have, and this will be starting next Monday, the Indiana State Department of Health will be opening a free COVID test site at the Woodlawn Specialty Clinic on State Road 25.
Oh.
The site will be open starting Monday, September 28th at 10 a.m. The state plans to operate this site until July of 2021, so we're about a nine-month period. This is not a Woodlawn Hospital test site. I want to just make sure everybody's aware. This is the State Department of Health. We're working with them to make sure that it works, but this is their site. Hours of operation, it will be Monday, Tuesday, and Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., Wednesdays from 9 to noon, Saturdays 8 to noon. We are closed on Thursdays and Sundays. The rapid testing will not be offered at this site. Appointments are not needed and not being scheduled. Testing will take place as a drive-up. You just stay in your vehicle. Somebody will come to your vehicle. No one under the age of 2 can be tested at this site. And minors need to be accompanied by a consenting parent or guardian. An email or cell phone will be needed to receive test results. Results will be provided by the Indiana State Department of Health within 3 to 7 days. So, doesn't do any good, come back to the site. They will not have the results. You will be either emailed or called. Again, results are not given out at the test site or by Woodlawn Hospital. We do ask if there is a line of traffic backed up, you know, please return at a later time. But no appointment necessary. Just drive in. You can get your COVID test, again, by the Indiana State Department of Health. The results will be given to you. It doesn't come to the hospital. Doesn't go to your physician. So that starts Monday. We're hoping that'll take some of the pressure off our ER. We're getting a lot of folks now that we're doing it. And, you know, it takes a nurse away from that ER to go out, do that test, and come back in. And there's, you know, unfortunately, a wait time for those folks that do that. So, again, sponsored by the Indiana Department of Health. No appointment necessary. Drive in. the state will contact you with those results.
Is this one of the sites where you need to be showing symptoms in order to get the testing done?
Absolutely not. You can just come in and request the test. There is some minor paperwork you have to fill out because they have to be able to contact you if the results would happen to be positive. But yeah, no appointment, no symptoms. You can just come in. It's a state-sponsored site and get your COVID testing there. Starts Monday at 10 a.m. at the specialty clinic on State Road 25, which is right next door to Tweedledee's. So it kind of gives you an idea, you know, from a geographic where it's at. So again, just come in and remember it is a state-sponsored site. They get you the results.
All right.
Kind of go back a little bit. We're still seeing, you know, some of the COVID in our area. So we still have the same visitation restriction we had before. One person per day. We are requiring masks in all the facilities. Again, the mask for our safety and all of our patients' safety does need to cover your nose. You know, a lot of folks come in, well, I got it over my mouth. Well, you breathe in and out of your nose, and it is a respiratory illness. So please put it over your nose and your mouth while in our facility because we have sick people in our building. And, you know, you could be that one person that is asymptomatic. You show no symptoms whatsoever, but still have the virus. So we just want to protect our staff and our other patients. Currently, we still need a physician order for the site at Woodlawn. So if you're, you know, need a rapid test, that will require a physician order to do that. Number two, we're kind of coming up onto flu season.
Right around the corner.
We're going from the frying pan into the fire, so to speak.
Yeah.
And I think it is very important this year that everybody really, really consider getting the flu shot. Is it 100% effective? No. You can still catch the flu even if you've had a flu shot. However, the symptoms are much less harsh on you. So, you know, last year I had a flu shot, and guess what? January I got the flu. But it was like a one day. Felt absolutely miserable for that one day. Come in, was tested positive for influenza A. But had I not had the flu shot, that could have been a 3 to 5 to 7 day period.
Right.
So we're really recommending get your flu shots. You know, CDC is again, best guess. They guess each year on what they think the virus is going to be, what strains, and that's what goes into the flu shot. And there's usually 5 to 7 different variants within that flu shot of the different flu viruses that's out there. 2 years ago, they missed it horribly. I don't think they got any of it right. But again, you just don't know. But it does, if you do get the flu, it will help you get over it much faster. And a lot of times, it will prevent you from getting the flu. So highly recommend getting flu shots. There are several locations around where you can get them free. I think some of the drugstores are, you know, free flu vaccines. You know, you can get it now. And I would recommend, again, after the first year. I mean, it does have a shelf life, so to speak, that for your protection. So, you know, I'll probably be getting my flu shot here in the next week or so, and I will probably get another one in January just to stretch it out a little farther. So highly recommend getting flu shots, especially this year because we're not going to be over the COVID.
Right.
I don't think we're going to have a COVID vaccine probably until the first of the year. And again, how effective is it going to be? We don't know. It's too many unknowns with it right now. So for your protection and your family's protection, do recommend the flu shots. Do want to announce that Dr. Tim Pullman, who's one of our general surgeons, has completed his Da Vinci robot training, and he is now doing robotic general surgery. So not only can we offer it for OBGYN, we can now do it for some general surgery cases. Can we do it on every single case? No, but a majority of the cases we can do this. And, you know, the robot just really reduces your recovery time. It's much less traumatic to the body by using the robot than if we do, you know, normal laparoscopic surgery. So, you know, he's very excited. He said it kind of has renewed him as a surgeon. It made him giddy using this. He said it's just that technology and what it allows him to do and the benefit to the patient is just something he would never dreamed, you know. He's been a surgeon for a while. He said, you know, 20 years ago, you never would have thought of this. He says, but now, you know, we've sent him to the training. He says, this is phenomenal what it does. So, you know, if you've got a surgical procedure, talk to Dr. Pullman and see if it would qualify for the robotic because it does reduce your recovery time substantially. We've had some of our OBGYN patients that before might have been a 3 to 5 day hospital stay are going home the same day with no complications. That is a big difference when you look from a quality of life. So the robotic surgery does make a difference as far as recovery time and your healing time. So strongly recommend, if you're, you know, needing some surgery, get a hold of Dr. Pullman. See if it qualifies for the robotic. The other thing that we're having right now, there is a, once again, we're into a nurse shortage again. So, you know, and I can understand, a lot of them are saying, I'm getting out of healthcare. It's mm-hmm. been tough on them this year.
Yeah.
You know, they've gone through a lot, and, you know, we don't understand what they go through, but, you know, I wear a mask maybe 5 hours out of a day. They're wearing an N95, you know, 12 hours a day. When they go home, they've got a bruise around their face from wearing that mask. So we're seeing an exodus, you know, a little bit of that. Folks saying, I just don't want to do it anymore. So it's a hard time finding nurses. So we've kind of put in some things that we really want to do, try to attract nurses to Woodlawn. We've got a $5,000 sign-on bonus. You know, we from a nurse to patient ratio, we kind of keep that low. We like to keep that at a 4-to-1. A lot of facilities are 6, 7, and 8-to-1 nurse to patient ratio. We do have a student loan forgiveness program, tuition reimbursement, very competitive pay, a healthy work environment, and we will educate you. If you need some additional education, you know, we'll help you with that, with, you know, additional education opportunities. So if you're a nurse looking for a change, you know, give our HR department a call and see if you can qualify for some of these programs. But again, it's, I think I'm biased, but it is a good place to work. I'm there every day and see what's going on. Do we have our days where, you know, it's stressful? Yes. But I think on the most part, we try to mitigate that the best we can. The other thing we had at a board meeting yesterday, we're required each year by some of our accrediting agencies that our director of maintenance, Brian Crawford, has to kind of give a state of the state address on where we're at with our infrastructure of the building. So he did that yesterday to the board and kind of went through a lot of areas that we're monitoring. We're in very good shape as far as the infrastructure of the building. There's probably 2 to 3 things that within the next few months we're going to have to look at. The roof is one of those, so we're in the process now of getting some bids to, you know, redo the roofing for the hospital. Some boiler maintenance work needs to be done. So what he does is kind of the board has an idea of where are we at from the building, what infrastructure are we looking at might need some improvement coming up. So we do that once a year, and that, you know, the board is very appreciative of that report we got yesterday. Finally got down to the financial report, and so for the month of August, had gross patient revenue about a little over $12 million. Our deductions or our write-offs was right at $7 million. We had other outpatient revenue, operating revenue, excuse me, of $1.6 million. Operating expenses was just a little over $5 million. So we had an operating income of about $741,000 for the month. Some non-operating revenue, about $181,000. So a net income of just a little over $920,000. Now, again, some of this is some of the government funds that we're bringing in. It was kind of interesting. We got the money several months ago. Yesterday, we finally got what we can use it for.
Oh, finally, huh?
So finally now we're starting to say, okay, we got this money, and a lot of it we've been setting on. We've just been putting in a reserve fund because we didn't know what we could use it for. So we'll, hopefully next week or so, we'll start going through. It's a 16-page document of how we can use those funds and start applying what we can use to it. Do I think we can use all of those funds we've got? No. We will probably send in some of the money back because we just don't qualify for it. So, you know, it's nice to have it, and, you know, but we will be making some refunds. I think we're not alone in that. I think a lot of hospitals will be sending several millions of dollars will be going back to federal government. I think they were a little aggressive just sending this money out because they didn't know how bad it was going to be when they started doing this, you know, back in March, April, and May.
Right.
So I think now we're catching up a little bit with some guidelines. How can we use the funds? So we're going to be sitting down, and I think it's going to take several hours going through the spreadsheets and the worksheets that they have, dropping our numbers in, and seeing how much of those funds we can use. But it's nice that we've had them just in case we needed them. But again, I don't want to be obligated. I don't want to be a wasteful of those resources. So some of the money will be going back. So that's, you know, kind of our future. In the next 2 to 3 months, I think we'll be going through that with our auditors and some of our consultants, help us determine where can we use these monies. So other than that, board meeting, about 3 o'clock we got done. So we covered a lot of material yesterday.
Yeah. Not a short span of time, but not a super long span of time.
Yeah, I guess it could have been worse, but you know, we covered a lot of subjects yesterday. You know, the budget process is starting, so we should have something going on that to the board, you know, October, November. So again, this time of year we start getting a little busy as we prepare for 2021.
Yeah. Well, I won't keep you, Mr. Alley. You've got a lot of work to do. You got a 16-page document to
I've
read
got
16 through.
16 pages I got to go through.
I'm glad I'm not the one who has to do it, and I wish you the best of luck on that.
Yeah, and the worst part of it, at the very last of that, the disclaimer is, all of this is subject to change.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm afraid what's happened, we're going to get all of this worksheet done, and I go, you know, we changed our mind, and we're going to have to redo it. But, you know, again, do the homework, see what we can do, knowing that we might make some changes to it as we go in the next few months.
Well, best of luck to you, and I look forward to seeing what you have to say about that 16-page document next month.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good one.